When I started looking after my calf, he was probably about 5 days old. My name is Davis and I'm in year six. The name of my steer is the Beef Lord, and he is quite chubby from eating all the grass and grain that we feed them. He's different because he's fatter and he's harder to catch on the halter, so we keep the halter on him the whole time.
So, I'm here with my good friend Bud Rhymes. Bud, what do you do around here?
I'm the teacher of the year 5 and 6 here at Danthonia.
And today, Bud is going to tell us a little bit about a project that the kids have been working on for some time now. Fire away.
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun. We've been taking care of one calf each with our year 5 and 6 students for now quite a few months. It's almost our spring time of year here, and last spring, when the cows calved, there were a number of orphan calves that didn't make it with the herd, and we took those and bottle fed them.
We bottle fed them twice a day. At the beginning, we only did 1 liter in the morning and evening, and then we moved on to 2 liters.
So we got to go skip class and bottle feed them, which was a lot of fun, just taking time with them. My name is Thomas, and I'm in year 5. I chose the name Gimli for my calf because I got the books read to me, Lord of the Rings, and he is just a cool name. And when I got him first, he was just a very small calf. I had good fun just going in the morning and feeding him and petting him and stuff.
So I'm just interested, when I was a kid, we learned to read and write and do arithmetic. Nobody ever brought a cow into my classroom. How does that go together?
Yeah, that's a good question. We haven't actually brought any cattle into the classroom yet, but we took the calves just in a year when we teach our children a lot of life science about the science that we see around us, the plants, the animals, and so on, and how they work. So what better than to have calves, which are of course living animals, and in them are growing organisms, and on the ground is vegetation that they eat, and so on. And so it all fits together quite nicely, and there was plenty of opportunity for teaching about that. And of course, one of the most important parts about education is catching the attention of the children, and nothing better to do that than a living animal that they love and enjoy.
My name is Kiara and I'm in year 6. We learned that calves have 4 stomachs and that the rumen is the biggest one and it takes up 75% of the cow. My calf's name is Midnight. She taught me that cows can have attitudes. If I'm like a little bit annoyed with her, she'll be annoyed too.
Well, you know how it is with animals. There's a real sense of responsibility when you have a living thing. So getting the calves for the children was a chance for them, in a way, to do something that every young child would like to do, but also to grow up as they took responsibility for this animal that needed to start with milk in a bottle and then eventually feed and grass and the moving of paddocks and so on. Not every school has a welly rack outside with lots of mud, but in the Bruderhof community, we like to do a lot of outdoor activity with the children and actually teach the whole child. So doing a calf program like this is perfect. It brings these different ideas into the classroom and gives us the opportunity to study life around us and God's creation with the children, and they always are in awe of the things they learn.
One thing I've learned is how to halter train young calves that are quite frisky and wild. Pulling up on the rope by their head when they're not coming, and then letting down a bit when they start walking forward to loosen on the back of their head.
While they were still small, we took a lot of time to tame them and follow the basic instructions that you'll hear from farmers about halter training animals. With a lot of rubbing and scratching and befriending of the calves, you gain trust with them. And then eventually we put a halter on them. And we took our time to tie up these halters ourselves. It's quite a process to teach them how to stay on a halter, because unlike a horse or a dog, they're not really wired to learn things fast about training. But they do take time and eventually manage. So we got all our calves on the halter. The calves do need shelter here. There's very little rain, but there's a lot of sun, and in the summer they need a good sunshade and also a supply of water. And because our design is that we move this herd of cattle around in the paddocks anywhere and everywhere, grazing areas around trees and funny corners where nobody else wants to mow, we have a calf hut, and we made that together with the children. It was a great opportunity to do building and putting in screws and steel. Now we have this hut that can be moved around with a forklift, and on it is a tank of water that can be filled up from a water trailer, and the calves always have a steady and ready supply of water. And then the fence attaches to this hut, and as we move the hut around, we just lift all the fencing parts onto the hut, move it, and then set the fence up again. Well, cell grazing is important because we learned a lot about the worm parasites that get into cattle. But one thing's clear about all of them, they all like to climb up the blades of grass and get into the cow, and then they lay their eggs inside the cow, and when they're excreted, they multiply and the eggs grow and hatch, and on we go again. So cell grazing is simply moving the cattle on fast enough so that those worms can't reproduce. Just when they're dangling on the end of the blade of grass waiting for a cow, the cattle have moved on and they only come back a long while later. And the other important aspect is here in Australia, where we're trying to care for our land through drought. It's very important to leave a lot of vegetation on the ground, about two-thirds of it, so that the ground is not affected by drought and manages to hold through. So we learned about that with the children and measured an area to figure out exactly what is a third, because it's hard to tell when you first look at it, and we need to educate ourselves so we know what that looks like every time we need to move the calves on.
So we move them around from different paddocks about once a week, and we're moving them around in our garden in the cover crop down there, where there's some nice green grass that they really enjoy. Yeah, the calves like the radishes, especially the tops.
In our garden, we work together with our gardener to use the calves as part of the garden rotation. People who are interested in regenerative gardening and getting away from pesticides and so on will know that the microbiology that's brought on from animals grazing on the land is a huge addition and helps the plants to be very robust and avoid disease. So we actually added our cattle into the rotation, and that means that they have an allotted moment to graze off a crop that's a cover crop. The gardeners might plant a tillage radish to help with the tillage of the soil, and some oats and other legumes, and then when it's finally time for it to be removed, instead of using machinery and rolling on the ground, the best thing that could possibly happen is that the cattle graze through it, and they also then put their manure on the ground, and that's very good fertilizer for the future, as well as introducing a lot of bacteria to the soil that will help in the future.
My name is Ailey and I am in year 4. I am an animal sort of person. My cow likes to be scratched on its belly, most cows do, and when we weigh the calves, we have to put a measuring tape around its belly, and then we figure out how heavy it is, and my calf was the heaviest of the whole herd.
Well, to monitor the amount of worm eggs that we had to do a test called a worm egg count, and it was quite exciting to go with the children around the paddock and collect the right samples of nothing other than feces and bring it up in a bag and then get out the microscope.
When we were testing them for eggs, we had to get the feces.
We learned from a local agronomist how to test that. So we got the microscope out and we had to mix the feces up with a salt solution, put it in a slide, and then stick it under the microscope. And what we were trying to do was find worm eggs and count the number of worm eggs per gram of feces. Lucky for us, we didn't find any, because that's really the goal. But we had some opportunities to find some worm eggs as well and learn what they look like and so on. And we look forward to testing the calves into the future and monitoring the worm count. That saves us from having to use the traditional drenching medicines. One of the last projects we've been doing has been making show sticks with the children. Now, usually you don't make your own show stick, because it's a stick that is made of some kind of special graphite, and goes to a show with you, and it's for scratching your cow while you show your prize winner to the crowds. But we made our own because we've seen the value of making it with the children, and we also don't quite know what the future is of our calves in regard to going to a show. But we did enjoy making the sticks and using them when we were practicing leading the calves around, and one day we do hope that we could bring them to a show.
So is the project complete, or where are we up to?
So I was prepared for this project to last maybe a good 6 weeks or maybe even 8 weeks. But the problem is that nobody wants to stop. All the children are very enthusiastic about it. So I'm going to try and make sure I know when the moment is to stop, but it's by no means ending. In fact, it seems to be a growing thing now, and the children want to keep it going, and there's no reason to stop because it's working out so well.
When my calf licks my hand, it feels kind of like there's sand on my hand.
Beef Lord is in the garden with the other calves. He recognizes me when I come to the paddock, but he's quite frisky and it's sometimes hard to catch him.
The best thing going to a school on a farm is like you can do stuff with animals. If there is poddy calves, you can have them and take care of them. I think like any kid who has the opportunity to ever have a poddy calf should take it and treat it very well. Spend time with it and make it their best friend.
I have enjoyed this project lots. Yeah, I would consider being a farmer.